What's up, guys? I'm here today. I'm gonna just do another tutorial on a good mix for a virtual DJ. So let's get started. All right, so I got virtual DJ pulled up, and so what you're gonna need for this is an acapella. So I'm gonna use three times, and an instrumental. So as you can see on the instrumental, I have a cue set up, and a cue is just like a starting point. So what I mean by that is you could just start the song from there. Okay, so this is a little bit more advanced than my last video. Like I said, like check out my last video, okay? This is just a different way to make a good quick mix. So yeah. So first what you want to do is, I'm going to just show you a nice little fade-in effect. Alright, so I'm going to put the volume all the way along the instrumental because I'm going to start off with that. So let's just play that first. You probably heard that because I set up my virtual DJ differently, but I'll do the fade-in now.
Sounds music. Move your body out on the floor. Put your troubles aside and start living. Anybody can let go. Throw away all your problems, cause right now it's party time. Girl, don't feel out of place, cause I'm in love with this feeling now. And I hope that this will last a while. We should make last a while. You gotta drink, so do we. Get my bottles, bring them to me. Hold your glasses up, people everywhere. Now everybody put your hands, everybody put your hands, everybody put your hands in the air, put your hands, everybody.
Alright, so, yeah, I mean, I wasn't really trying too hard on that, but it sounded pretty good, right? Anyway, so, all I did was use a few loops, that fade-in effect, and a cue, and an acapella song, and an instrumental song. If you don't know what a loop is, you just loop the song, that's all it is. Let me show you what I mean by that.
Move your body!
So I'm gonna loop that. So I just put a little loop.
Move your back, move your back.
Here just loops it, and then you can make a loop longer by hitting this arrow right here, or shorter by hitting this arrow. Perfectly timed loops make a mix sound so much better, trust me guys. Cues are pretty awesome also. Effects, as you probably heard, I used Flanger. It had like that kind of robotic noise. If you hit this little tab right here, you get a ton of effects. Then you can just activate it by hitting it, it'll turn blue. So, it's pretty cool. Good effects, makes the mix sound better also. And you have samplers, so I'll give you an example of that.
Winning.
So, yeah. Samplers are pretty good also. I usually use them, before a song or towards the end of a song. Not really in the middle, unless it's mostly instrumental. Yeah, an acapella, if you didn't know what that was, it's just the music, or the song without the music. A good acapella, or any acapella actually, but with a good instrumental, could sound really good, like the one I just did. It sounded pretty good. The instrumental had a few words in it, but, you know, it sounded okay. And if you time it perfectly, it sounds really, really good. I talked about the sync in my last video, so check that out. Try to match the BPMs, guys. That's really, really important. What I mean by that, it's just the beats. So if I have a slow song, so I'll just, for example, just slow the song down. Or speed it, or, yeah, slow it down. It sounds like this.
Move your body out on the floor. Put your troubles aside and start living.
Sounds really bad, trust me. Just trying to match the BPMs. If you hit sync and the BPMs aren't matching, you might get something like this.
Move your body out on the floor. Put your troubles aside.
It's not the case in this song, but I'm just showing you an example of what could happen if you don't have matched songs. Other than that, you know, it's pretty straightforward. Just play the instrumental and, you know, time the acapella and, you know, play it, and it'll sound pretty good. It sounds pretty professional because, I don't know, it just sounds really good, I'm telling you. I'm not a fantastic DJ, but I'm telling you, some of my stuff sounds sweet just because I use simple stuff like this. And once you get it down and you know your effects and you could do cool stuff, it just sounds so much better. So, yeah, if you have any questions or recommend any videos or any tutorials you want me to do, if you want to know how to scratch or do certain things, leave a comment. I'll make a video quick. I'll answer you. Other than that, guys, see ya. You know, rate, comment, and subscribe. Peace out.